Hi folks, I'm Mark, this is Tania and Aaron. Today we bring you a huge topic, which is how to bid, but more importantly to win at your next auction.
And we know not everyone goes to auction on a regular basis, and we also know there's not a lot of good quality information out there to help buyers to upskill you so that you can help get your next property.
So this video today is going to give you some hints, some tactics, some tricks to help you at your next auction.
Now, tip number one, we suggest getting there a little bit early, perhaps about 30 minutes prior, to give you time for a couple of things. Firstly, grab your photo ID, go to the registration desk and get your lucky bidder's panel number. And secondly, gives you a bit more time to look around the property again and keep an eye out for your competition.
Tip number two, are you bidding by yourself? Why don't you bring a friend or a family member just as a bit of moral support or someone just to have a chat to?
Okay, tip number three, let's talk money. Everyone wants to talk money. Now, it's really important when you set your maximum price before you get to the auction that it's not a round number, because too many buyers work in round numbers, 500,000, 700,000, whatever it might be. So you need to set yourself a little bit of a buffer so it can give you the best chance of buying the property on the day.
Tip number four, whereabouts do you position yourself at the auction? Well, we believe to the side of the auctioneer is an excellent strategy. The reason for that is you have a direct line of sight of them, but you can also keep an eye on the other bidders. And the reason that's important is that their body language may give you a bit of a tell as to if they're nearing their limit.
Tip number five, bid confident, act confident. Don't wait for the auctioneer to call out the number. Be confident and call out yours, 500,000.
Tip number six, take control of the bidding amount. As an example, the auctioneer might be asking for a $10,000 bid and you might decide to do a $20,000 or $30,000 bid to show that you're in control. Another great time to use this, if another buyer is using a $1,000 or a $2,000 bid, you might come over the top and use a $5,000 or a $10,000 bid to show your confidence and to show that you're in control.
Tip number seven, in a situation where you're there with your partner, it's very important to decide who's going to hold on to the bidder's paddle. Oh, I've got this one. And the reason for that is you need to decide who's going to be confident. You've already decided on your price and you don't want people seeing you in conflict during the bidding itself.
Tip number eight, just bid quickly. You'll take that next bid while other people get left behind when they're still deciding.
Okay, tip number nine, don't be afraid to hit your top price first. So towards the end of the auction, if the bidding increments are reducing to $1,000 or $2,000 bids, you might decide just to go straight to your maximum, your buffer price, again, with confidence straight away. And even if it's your final bid, do so with confidence, because the buyers are probably gonna think you've still got more money behind you.
So there we go, folks, nine tips and tricks for you. From now on, you can have a game plan, you can turn up and be prepared, and most importantly, have fun and good luck at your next auction.